Final Cut is an amazing editing software, but one thing it lacks is advanced color grading features. It seems quite a few Final Cut users are switching over to DaVinci Resolve for this reason. But in my opinion, they don't need to be. The majority of them, at least. The reason being, the plugin Color Finale 2 Pro has a lot of the same important tools and features that DaVinci Resolve has when it comes to color grading, and you never have to leave Final Cut's UI. Now, I know some of you might be Resolve users who clicked on this video ready to tear me a new one. So I need to preface by saying that DaVinci Resolve is a gold standard when it comes to color grading. But for the majority of creators who use Final Cut, other than maybe professional colorists, Color Finale 2 Pro can absolutely get the job done and is infinitely better than Final Cut's native tools. Here's why. Color Finale 2 Pro allows you to dial in big gradual adjustments with the standard color wheels, which you can do with Final Cut's native built-in tools, obviously, but it also has log wheels like DaVinci Resolve does to help give your footage little pushes to fine-tune things without making big linear adjustments. For example, you have a shot where your exposure is sitting at a level you'd like it to be at, but it seems your highlights are clipping just a bit. Instead of pulling down the exposure of your highlights using your primary wheels, which, as you can see, makes more of a gradual adjustment to your shot, affecting different luma values other than just your highlights, using the log wheels allows you to essentially compartmentalize that adjustment, so the rest of your shot's exposure sits exactly where you'd like it to be. The same goes for adding a bit of color. If you want a small push of orange in your highlights to fine-tune your look without affecting the rest of your shot, you can make the adjustment in your log wheels. So just like Resolve's primary and log wheels, you have more control over your hue, saturation, and luma values than you do with Final Cut's native tools. One of the things that got me interested in DaVinci Resolve was the ability to use qualifiers to isolate specific sections of your shot to make more precise adjustments. Final Cut Pro gives you a similar option using an HSL mask, but the issue lies in a lack of a blur or smoothing feature that makes these changes more gradual. Why is this Resolve feature important? Let's say you really want a certain look. I've already made a selection protecting our talent's skin and isolating the background. If you really try to dial in a certain look, your image might start to break apart. You can clearly see where the selection chosen for her skin is and where the selection chosen for this added blue color is. It looks terrible. And this is something that unfortunately happens with the native tools in FCP if you're really pushing your colors around. But all it takes is some blur from the HSL selection and you get a way smoother gradation of colors. The image smooths out and the adjustment looks way more natural. This is a feature that is essential to creating better looking color grades, and it's one of the big pros of the plugin for me. Color Finale 2 Pro also supports an Aces workflow. It allows users to perform Aces color transformations with the plugin and work in the Aces color space. If you're unsure of what Aces is, it is a set of rules and guidelines set up in order to standardize color so that creators' work will look the same on any display. Ideally, you'd want to select Aces if you're working within an Aces pipeline, but you can still apply it to shots for general color grading, even if you don't have to provide an Aces compliant master, which Final Cut cannot. I shot this with a Sony a7S III in S-Log 3. All I did was add the Sony Log to Rec 709 Transform LUT, and this is with the Aces color management instead. Obviously, it adds more contrast, so just for this explanation, let me add a bit back into the standard clip. And you'll see that not only is the highlight roll-off prettier and smoother with Aces, but look at her skin as I go back and forth. The color science of Sony cameras is known to add a bit of yellow, greenish tint to skin tones, and an Aces color transform takes this into account and transforms it into a shot that's more realistic to how the image looked at that location. This is a feature that Final Cut does not have native, unfortunately. Something else that's enticing about Resolve, and something which we've been asking Apple for a long time, is the ability to name and group color corrections. You can rename color masks in FCP, so why not the corrections themselves? Who knows? Nevertheless, you can in Color Finale 2 Pro. This just makes it infinitely easier to see what you have going on and stay organized. The grouping feature also comes in handy for organization, as well as using some of the masking features, because then those masking selections can apply to multiple corrections in the group at once. The other thing that the plugin has that Resolve has, which is very useful in making isolated corrections, are all of the different masking features. We already went over the HSL mask, but these options are similar to power windows in Resolve, and they're all trackable as well. You have these masks available in FCP's native tools, but the plugin also gives you this edge mask, which allows you to make a graduated linear adjustment, similar to tools in Lightroom. And the B-spline mask and the Bezier path are essentially the draw mask tool in Final Cut Pro, but for color corrections. You also have an image mask, which lets you make adjustments to ranges of value or brightness in your shot. You can use the image mask in tandem with blend modes to give a little pop to the bright areas of your shot. This is something that Resolve has that Final Cut does not have natively, the ability to adjust blend modes on individual corrections. Now this brings me to the last bit where I reiterate that this plugin is not the color grading powerhouse that Resolve is. It can be buggy at times, and it definitely does not have as many features. Nevertheless, the point of this video is not to say that the plugin is better, because it is certainly not. It is to show you that this plugin has Resolve features that I believe can satisfy the vast majority of FCP creators' color grading needs. And it can save those who like editing in Final Cut the hassle of having to switch to another software. If you're curious to try it out for free, I'll put a link in the description. And if you would like to pick it up, I'll also put a discount code that I was able to pick up for you guys. And I hope you guys have a great rest of your day. Have fun creating.